actually, we are talking about the promotion that is running as if it's a military system. They are by creating administrative inefficiencies. In my line of work as a consultant, he says that there's a dissonance gap between what you profess to be and what you are practicing. Therefore, we are going to have frustration. What I mean by demographic inequalities? The youth in this country, ages 19 to 35, are 63.1 million. They constitute 33% of the population, yet they are underrepresented in governments, and they are some particularly representation in governments. And so what do we have? We have a country that is looking for fresh ideas, but how are we going to get fresh ideas for people who don't even understand how to operate a smartphone? We are asking for an impossibility. The third one is religious illogicality. It boils down to a simple question. Why do Nigerians seek divine intervention in commonsensical ways? Let me break down these illogicalities for you, and you see how the inefficiency of our conceptual illogicality has led to some of the problems that we have. Let's take our energy policy. We need what you can term energy federalism. Now, what is happening is that the word federalism itself has been so bastardized in Nigeria that all people think about is state police and resource control. But that is not the essence of federalism. The essence of federalism is the leveraging of nativism for efficient administrative and delivery of governance values to the people. Therefore, the people in the East can leverage the nativism and all the resources that are there, including the climatic conditions. The people in the North can do the same. The people in the South South can do the same, and the people in the West can do the same. It doesn't matter. What we need to do is to pay attention to our nativism and then bring those things to deliver results for our people. If you look at the map of Nigeria, and I'm sure that what is mentioned to you now, you will discover that your energy policy is wrong. Lagos has wind power. We have the Atlantic. Ideally, therefore, what we should be running in Lagos is wind power turbines and hydropower. If you look at the north, the average temperature in the north is 36 degrees centigrade. Therefore, they have no business using any other thing except solar power. If you go to the south-south, you are going to find that they have hydropower, and they have natural gas, and they have wind as well. Therefore, the energy policy is to be fossil fuel, natural gas, and hydropower. And in the east, they have coal, and they have hydropower. Therefore, what we should be talking about is clean coal and hydropower. Now, of course, when you suggest things like this, people are going to tell you it's impossible. And yet, China has a wind turbine capacity of 104,763 megawatts. That's the biggest wind power sector in the world, 31% of the global total. America has 65,879 megawatts. Germany has 39,169 megawatts. Nigeria, in total, I'm not talking about wind power, hydropower, anything, in total, we have 7,124 megawatts. We've been talking about reaching 10,000 megawatts for the past 15 years. It's a moving target.
In progress.
What are the implications if we follow a federated energy policy? I know I'm throwing crazy ideas out there, but at this stage in which we are in, we need all the crazy ideas that we can get. Assuming that the North goes solar, the first thing that happens is that you cut off the North from the national grid.
Mm-hmm.
That frees capacity for the rest of the country. The second thing that will happen is that you boost unemployment, boost employment, need solar industries, fund employment. You are going to have solar panels, solar roofing sheets, solar cars, battery industry. Why are they driving fossil fuel cars in the north when they should be driving Teslas?
Yeah.
It's a question. Number three, new specialties will lead to reform in the educational sector, because then you have to train engineers. So illustrate what I'm trying to say. I'm trying not to get away from this man because I know that he's being recorded, but I'm so agitated with energy. It's like I'm on Red Bull. I designed two adverts for you to see what will happen if we promote a federated tourism in the north. Number one advert says, I'm going to show the adverts. The camels from Dubai have a $10 for hours. They don't know how to dress.